We deal with several solids in our daily lives. They are of different sizes and shapes. While some solids are made up of flat surfaces, some are made up of curved surfaces. And some are a combination of flat and curved surfaces. This is a can of soft drink. It's made up of one curved surface and two flat surfaces. The line where one continuous smooth surface meets another is called an edge. We use certain conventional or accepted rules while representing certain special solids so that it becomes easy for us to visualize these objects quite accurately. For example, each face is defined by the lines enclosing them. The edges that are visible from the angle of view are given boldly, while the other edges, which are not visible from the angle of view, are given in dotted form. For example, the three edges of the pyramid that are not visible from this angle are indicated by dotted lines. Now let us take a box and view it from this angle. These are the faces in direct view from this angle. These are the defining lines that are in our view, so we draw them with bold lines. We then draw dotted lines to represent the edges that are not visible. The representation of the solid on paper is now complete. Let us now take a look at how we draw a cube, cuboid, prism, and pyramid. This is a cube. It is made up of six square faces. This is how we represent it from the angle at which we are viewing it now. This is a cuboid. It's made up of six rectangular faces. This is how we represent it from the angle at which we are viewing it now. This is a triangular prism. It has two identical faces parallel to each other. If we were to cut the solid parallel to these faces, we will see that the cross-section obtained will be exactly like the two identical faces. This solid has five faces altogether. This is a different prism. Note that the parallel faces now have five sides. The total number of faces of this prism is seven. This is a cylinder. You can see that a cylinder is a prism with a circular base and one curved surface. This is a pyramid. Pyramids have a flat base. The area of the cross-section of a pyramid reduces as we move up the solid, finally culminating at a point. The base may have any number of sides, the smallest being three. The faces forming the sides of the pyramid are all triangles. These triangles meet at one point. This figure is a solid cone. It is made up of one flat surface and one curved surface. A cone is similar to the pyramid, but has a circular base. Now let us see what we mean by a net. The net of a solid is a flat figure that can be folded to get the shape of the solid. The lines are the places at which the folds occur. Note that when we draw a net, we have each face sharing at least one of its sides with another face. Thus, a net is a view of the solid's surface spread flat. In other words, the net of a solid is actually a two-dimensional figure that may be folded to form the three-dimensional solid. Now let us make a net for this cuboid. Note that this net is not unique. This means that there can be a different net for the same cuboid. As long as a net can fold into the required solid, we say that it is a net of the given solid. We can say this is a net of the solid given because it can be folded to get the shape of the solid. Can you guess which is the net corresponding to the given solid? We see that only net B can be folded to get the given solid. So the net corresponding to the given solid is B. In order to find the net of a solid, always note the number of faces the solid has and the shape of the faces of the solid carefully first, and then proceed to visualize whether the net can be folded to get the given solid.